What's up, guys? Welcome back. It's good to see you. It's good to see everybody. All right, so live streaming today. It's like the old days. I'm just gonna be chilling, making some work. I'm working on this dichroic Sherlock for a friend, and I may work on this other Sherlock or something. But anyway, if you guys have any questions or want to chat about anything, just put it up there in the chat. And tell me where you're from. I haven't been super streaming lately or anything really, because I went to Burning Man and that took a lot of preparation. And then right after Burning Man, I went to a retreat and that took a lot of time, and then kind of getting back to normal life. So that kind of happened in September, and then I kind of took September and October a little bit to just unwind and relax and check in with myself. So yeah, here I am, here you are. So let's blow some glass and hang out for an hour. And if you want to chat about anything, just put it up there. I quit smoking nicotine. This is day three now, and I got a patch. So I'm smoking a CBD spliff, which is nice. And I've been doing good with the quitting. So I think I got it this time. The first time I've had a patch. All right. Kenzo, will you send a link of this to Michelle and to Roy in the group chats? Thanks. All right, here we go. So we got some people. We got Mobius in Arizona. It's, let me know where you're from. There's other people in here. Is it warm in Berkeley? Not really. It's like, what? Probably in the 50s in Berkeley. From Seattle, Washington, Canada. A lot of places. All right, let's see. Let's just encase an opal to start off. Why not? Colorado. We got 22 people in the room. Oregon. Sure, a lot of places. Asheville is beautiful. Asheville, Oregon. Or Asheville, North Carolina. It's Ashland, Oregon. Yeah, I love Asheville and Ashland. I bet it's warmer in Berkeley than a lot of places, though. Let's see what we got. 59 in Berkeley right now. Kenzo, it's 59 in Berkeley. Yes. Make sure you guys think, Kenzo. He's really the brains of the operation over here. He's doing all the video stuff so that you and me, we can just have fun and blow glass, and Kenzo makes it look pretty. Dan K, if you want to chat with me privately, just send me a message on Instagram. And I'll get it on Instagram. It's a good way to text me. Any of you guys, if you guys want to text me something, you can do it. Or the website, send me a message on the website. I get them, I read them. If I don't read them, somebody close to me reads them and lets me know. Lets me know what I should respond to. All right, so we don't want to touch the opals with our fingers, because that'll get oils on it. So I usually have a pair of wood tweezers, but I don't know where they are, and I didn't look for them. Yep, Kenzo's got the angles on lock. How many angles we got, Kenzo? 4, 5? Got a kiln shot? 4? We got 4 right now. Sometimes we go up to 6. Oh, I know. But the opals, I'm working on the Sherlock. I'm just putting some opals on. Kenzo, will you refresh my video? right, so we're just letting this opal sink in there a little bit. Going to town on this thing. The best way to use the opal, well, this is one way to use the opal. It's putting it in a clean 12 millimeter tube, but don't touch the glass or the opal very much. And put it in and kind of just let gravity do its thing. Slowly, slowly, it'll sink in. Sometimes you can get them just perfect off the get, but most of the time you have to peel. This one I'm gonna get, but I'll do another one. I'm sure it won't work out perfectly. And then you peel off the excess glass, and that kind of removes any of the air bubbles. Mobius, how do you keep the silver from burning off? You have to work the glass cooler. And that means that as you see the glass start to heat up, you move it out of the flame a little bit or to the other side of the piece. And that's super important to keep it from burning. It's gonna let your color, it's gonna like take longer because you can't like forcefully like melt in your color, but it'll work, but it just takes a little bit longer. What kind of torch are you using, Mobius? Hey Trey, well thanks for catching the live. And I'm honored that I played a part in you doing glass. I mean, I think I played a minor part. I mean, I wouldn't exactly describe it as you, but you know, you're the one who ordered all this stuff and took all the time out of your life and did all that shit to make it happen. All I did was put up a YouTube video, man. Just a crazy guy with a camera and a torch. All right, we got the opal connected. Send me a link. Kenzo, will you text me a link to this? Okay. All right, just take your time, exactly. That's the whole thing about this whole process, actually. Just take your time, don't rush it. Just be with the process, like enjoy the process. Not the final product will be cool, but you're blowing glass because you love the process a lot. You know, that's the only way you can stay with it. Using a Nortel Red Max. Yeah, Nortels tend to, the Red Max especially, tends to produce a little bit of reducing flame. So just be mindful of that. Yeah, Brett, well, thanks for checking it out. And I'm really glad that you like the live streams. We'll try to do them more often. I remember in COVID, we did it every day, but we'll try to get on some sort of regular schedule. Yeah, it's a different experience. A lot of times, I mean, it depends on the piece, but especially the early videos, Brett, they weren't edited very much at all as far as things taken out. Now with like very complex pieces, like the one that I made with Pyro, for example, that took like 4 days. And so there was no way we could have edited that down. I mean, that's why we had to make 2 videos. So, but yeah, especially the early ones, you can see the really unedited stuff. More simple pieces. And in this way, it's also like all in real time. Sometimes the videos, we speed it up a little bit. Yeah, exactly. Lucy drop, right? It's like, I'm just doing my thing and stoked that you guys are here with me. Well, I appreciate that, Caden. Yeah, you know, I think there's a balance, you know, like staying humble for me and also knowing that the impact that I have had and you know, there is more work to do. There's always work to do. It's important to not be unrealistic in either direction, but have the humility while also knowing your worth, I guess. The balance. What is the most important thing to work on when you're just starting? What do you think the most important thing to work on when you're just starting is, Kenzo? What is it? Patience. Kenzo says patience. That's a good one. Yeah, just, I mean, like, work on a schedule. Like, work on doing it every day. And just doing it. Just do it and do it and do it. Doesn't really matter what you practice, I guess, is what we're saying. What matters is you're practicing. Practice something that's fun for you. Practice something that you can succeed at sometimes and fail at sometimes. So it's pushing your skill level. All right, I'm gonna pick out a little bit of this clear glass here. Melt that in. All right, put that in the kiln. Let's see what time that is. 4:15. All right. I'm gonna text this to a couple people. 1 second. Second, you guys, I'll be right back with you. And I just wanted to send this link to a couple people. Say again, Kenzo? You sent it. I sent it. Yeah, sent it. Cool. All right, so I haven't tried out the Hydra. Maybe I have tried the Hydra. I probably tried it because I did all these torches reviews on my website with Mountain Glass Arts, and I probably tried it. I have to look at the video to see which one it was to give you any real feedback, because I tried like 30 torches in the same day. Just no matter what you're working on, Lucy Drop says, no matter what you're working on, focus on how the glass moves, where you put the heat, and learn to repeat. That's pretty good advice. Once you learn the glass, you win. It's true. Once you know glass and the logic and the technique behind it, it doesn't really matter. You can make anything. I mean, I can make anything. I could practice. I would need to practice for some things. But the logic for glass is the same universally. And so even if I hadn't made something before, if it was a fairly simple thing, I could just understand how to do it and make it. Sounds like a 1990s song. Beginner's guide. I know, huh? We're stuck in the 90s over here. Sarah loves the opals. Yeah, well, when we pull the pipe back out, Sarah, maybe Kenzo will get a close-up of the opals so you can check them out. Yeah, especially Mobius has a good point. He says, he's been blowing glass just a couple of months and made all 50 spoons, and how much he improves after each one. And that's what's really cool about glass. And one of the things that's true about glass is that each one at the beginning, you get so much better. Well, you notice it so much better. And as you progress and progress, those jumps become further and further apart, you know, and every piece still gets a little bit better, but but you already reached a certain level. Thanks, Mr. Zoso. Sometimes people call us reverse glass, and it's kind of funny. Maybe I should make like another brand called Reverse Glass. What do you guys think? Implosion marbles, that's a good one. It doesn't matter, anything. Anything that interests you. Anything that sparks your fancy. Have you guys heard that expression? How many people have heard somebody say that in like a real context, like sparks your fancy? All right, we have 54 people in the room. I appreciate that. Thanks guys so much for checking it out. If you guys want, you could check out the new shirts that I released. You know, everyone's always asking about my shirts and where I get them, and you know, I told you guys before that I designed them. So I made a few designs available. There's only a couple of sizes in each one, but they're on my website and at DustinRevere.com if you want to check it out. Not revereglass.com. And yeah, their shirts are cool. I'm wearing one of them now. Yeah, jump right into glass blowing. Have fun. Do it for the love. Do it for the love, and you can do it every day. Keep it in your life. That's a secret too. A lot of people, it's hard to keep in their life, you know, kids, jobs, money, whatever. And so just holding on to it, doing it, it's like an exercise. Just keep on doing it. Don't let too much stuff build up in your studio. Like clothes or other tools, like keep your studio ready to work. All right, pop that off. It goes on the floor. That's okay, we didn't need it. All right, let's open this tube up and connect these two. We got 52 in the room. Where is everybody from? Who's from another country? All right, make that connection. It's a little bit, not quite as clean of a connection I want, so I'm gonna go back in there. Just clean it up a little bit, put a little bit more heat there. All right. Connect those two. Now I'm gonna remove this one. Canada, there's a couple people from Canada. HK, does that mean Hong Kong? You from Hong Kong, that HK, is that what that stands for? Brazil, cool. Thanks you guys, thanks for telling me you're from another country. From Colombia, me and Oh, Ross Vincel's from Colombia. And Sabrina's from Mexico. Beautiful. It's good to see you guys. I have a close friend who I love very much. He's Colombian. And I just met somebody from Mexico. I'm excited to get to know. So Hong Kong. So here's my question for you guys in other countries. Is there a translation thing that you're using so that you can get the subtitles and then what I'm saying? So that's what we're looking into right now. And I'm wondering if any of you guys who speak different languages, if there's anything that you're able to do, or you just know English and you know that's what you do too. But yeah, that's my question for you guys. Well, you know, I haven't been streaming in a second, but, you know, I'm going to try to do it more. I love to be with you guys and hang out with you. And I have a team kind of that I've been building, so I think we can do it a little bit more. So natural powerlifting, you're in Ukraine. Tell me, man, is there anything I can do for you to make your life a little bit easier? How is life in the Ukraine? Could be pretty tough, I heard, right now. But, you know, who knows? Who knows what's true from what somebody would be there then than what I would hear on NPR. Glassblowing, turning arsonists into artists. Yep, it's true. There's some truth to that. Catfish Actual in New Mexico, Missouri, we got it all. Caden, which part of it? Las Vegas, I'm not going to be going to Las Vegas in January. I'm not ready. I don't have a body of work quite ready yet. And I mean, I maybe go, maybe it'd be nice to see some old friends, but not really, just maybe next year I'll be ready. Yeah, pretty rough. Sorry about that. I would end war if I had that much power. Mr. Zoso. I like that name. I think that's kind of smooth, Mr. Zoso. So, well, I'm glad to hear that you've worked through your medical stuff and you're able to build glass again. It's important. It's healing. It's meditative. Be with the flame. Chill. All right. Colorado. I like Colorado. Yeah, I saw that the Ukrainian, a lot of people were booking Airbnbs in Ukraine and not, obviously not going, and just giving the money to the host family who, you know, that's their income. Today I'm working on a Sherlock for a friend right now. And I was just condensing this radicello tubing. So I think I'm going to make a carb of it. You guys, check this song out. This is the song that we used in the last video that we put up, which is a kind of a Burning Man recap. You might want to check that out. This is the song that we used. So I think every time I hear it now, you know, I'm going to think of that. But that's what happens when you use a song for a video. Every time you, because you watch that video so many times while you're editing it and stuff. Does that happen to you, Kenzo? Every single time, right? It's like you hear the song and you're like, you can see the video in your head. Yeah, Mr. Zoso. So we met before? Tell me about that. Maybe I don't recognize the name. Alright, so we have this hole open. I'm not sure exactly how I'm gonna use this yet, so I'll just kind of put this back in the kiln like this. I know I'm gonna probably connect a blow tube, but I don't know the size yet or the shape. So I'll put this back in the kiln and I'll do another opal. Let's see, we got two opals here. Here's a good one. This one, I'm not super stoked with. I don't know if you can see that, but it's kind of white versus this one. Can you give me a close up here, Kenzo? Let's see. Back more towards here? Yeah, okay. Cool. So, yeah, I got the two opals. You can see this one on the left is like kind of white, and this one has a sparkle to it. So, I don't know. Maybe it's too thick, but I'm not going to use it. Now we do another opal. Okay. So this was in the kiln for 10 minutes. Let's see, let's put it here. I think it's a good spot right here. So I'm gonna heat it up a little bit, just enough so that it kind of form, become one piece as I put it on. Okay. Heat that up. Connect it. All right, now I'm gonna remove the putty. All right, well, Sarah, thank you for saying that. I appreciate that. I remember when I was first starting off with glass, you know, I had like a, I was kind of awkward and just wasn't super good at communicating yet. And I remember blowing glass and making objects that people would think were beautiful. And I was like, wow, this is so cool. I can express beauty without language. And that really was a big deal for me, to feel like I could say or show something beautiful that came from me without language. Let's take a little bit of this glass out of here. Okay, melt that in again. Oh yeah, if you guys want to see that, oh, I guess you can see them pretty good on here. Kenzo's got a nice shot. All right. Cool. So we got that opal on. I think we need a few more opals on here, don't you guys think? Maybe even a Marini? I mean, how crazy are we gonna get? Fuck, I don't know. How crazy are we gonna get? Oh, my friend is texting me. I'm just gonna send him the link. The link to it. Whoops. We'll send one to Gus too. Gus Glass just texted me, called me. I like Gus Glass a lot, so we'll send him a message with it as well. All right, now let's see what time it is. 4:32. So put that in the kiln at 4:31 or second or so, and we're gonna take it. I'm like doing like 10-minute intervals right now with that thing. It's kind of big. I mean, it's maybe I don't quite need 10, but I'm doing about 10-minute intervals just to keep it safe. So I'll make another pendant, work on another opal, make some other prep stuff, get that ready. Lee, you changed your handle. Good to see you, man. Well, there's not been a lot happening. I've been kind of taking a break. And so I'm working on pipe level 2 right now. And there's a bunch of video stuff that I've been doing, but you hadn't really missed much. We put up a couple things, but not too much. Good to see you, Lee. And you changed your name. I was like, who's got that blue wrench? Who has that special moderating power? Yeah, you think we should go crazy for this Sherlock? On the Sherlock and Marini too? Might as well. Let's do it. I hope she likes it. All right, opal time. All right. This is a little tricky, this one. This opal being difficult. What should I do, Kenzo? Kenzo basically knows the answers to whatever. whatever I ask him, unrelated to his experience, but he'll still know the right deal. Oh shit. Did you see I almost got it? There we go. Boom. Did it. That was easy. I just made it look hard. All right. Well, no, opals aren't super hard to work with. You can burn them out if you get them too hot or too much oil. Yeah, so, but you can burn them out. They're not super hard to work with. It's a synthetic opal, which is a Gilson opal. Yes, that's right. Matt, sorry, I misread that. Matt Brodman is saying this correctly. This is either a synthetic opal or the brand Gilson, which makes the synthetic opal. Black opal, well, like all synthetic opals work kind of the same. Here, all right, check this out, you guys. So this is kind of normally what happens if you encase an opal. So I have this bubble right here. Can you guys see that? Yeah, I think you can see that actually. Cool, so I'm gonna take this, I'm gonna what's called skin the opal. And that's gonna take that bubble off. I think my friend might have joined the chat because he sent me back a text. So if he's here, maybe what's up to him? What's up, Tim Carlton from Sleepy Hollow? All right, you cannot use real opals. They have moisture in them. And that will be no good. You can't really encase, opals have too much moisture. So I'm heating it up and picking it and pulling it. Just pulling this off, like that. And that's getting that bubble to move to the top. You got 71 people in here. 23 likes. What's going on, you guys? Thumbs up if you're hanging around. It really helps the video and helps the channel, and we want to grow the channel. If I get a silver play button, I'll encase it in glass or something. All right, heat that up and pull that off. So now we got the opal skin. You can see it's fully encased and clear. But it's not got much on it, so we're gonna put more clear on the top. And this is just a clear rod. All right, so my friend doesn't know how to, he's watching the video, but he doesn't know how to comment because he doesn't know what a computer is. I'm just kidding. Sign in, you gotta sign in to comment, man. You gotta sign in and then you'll see the comments on the right probably, but we love you. I love your ability to use technology no matter what level. Okay, what's going on in the camera? Yeah, the finger oil issue is true. You got to be mindful with your opals. Moldavite. Yeah, I put up a video I think it's on YouTube, how to use moldavite in a pipe. And there's other ways too, of course, besides the way that I put it on, but you check that out if you want to see how to make a pipe out of a meteorite. All right, so now I'm pushing the new clear rod over the opal and kind of squeezing that together. And if you want, you can twist this, and that can sometimes bring that opal right into the center. See how I did that? I moved the opal to the center. Now, let's take this off here. I'll melt this back and then we'll put this piece on. And then we'll probably put it in the kiln and make another couple of things to attach maybe. Because we still have a few minutes before I want to take the piece out again. right. Any Millie? Yeah, that's what we're thinking about doing, Lee, is we're thinking about putting a Millie on here too. My friend wanted me to like add some decoration stuff on the bottom there. Yeah, Space Tech is a good one. That's fun. Well, fuming with copper and other metals is not super, I don't know, I don't really like it. I come from a family of jewelers and my dad's a goldsmith, so I tried all kinds of metals and yeah, I don't really like fuming with copper and platinum doesn't really do it. I think the best bet you might want to try is making your own alloys. So like mixing your 24 karat gold with some copper or some nickel or some silver and kind of just making your 24 karat gold a little bit less, that can have some different effects. Yeah, Jamie shop mate melted opal moldavite into a piece, into like a whole section, and that's another thing you can do with it. All right, so here's the next opal. Now you can see there's no bubble, right? And that's why we skinned it. 79 people. Oh, we got 41 likes. Thanks, you guys. That makes me feel better. All right, so we'll put that in the kiln for next time. It's a little bit short, but we can do it. Then I have like a cup of Millies. Maybe, do I have that cup of Millies around here? Huh. I don't know. I don't see it right off the bat. But it's like a whole cup of Millies, and I could use that. All right, well, I don't have that. So let's see, I have this other dichroic section. Oh, Mobius, you really just need like the simple kind of crucible, like a tiny one to do that. Or even graphite, you can totally make an alloy in just graphite. Carbon, and that works well. I've done that before many times. All right, now we're going to put together some sections of this other, let's try this other dichroic section. All right, it's good to see all you guys. I missed you. Yeah, 3-inch wide, 3-inch. That's pretty big still. You only need to do so little of these different alloys, but as long as you just use a little bit, it should work just fine. All right. So I have this special section of Dichro we're gonna use. Make some blanks out of that. Make another Sherlock. You guys like Sherlocks? I think Sherlocks are a pretty fun shape to make, and a lot of people like them a lot. Here. I'm gonna put this in the Nikola. You guys can check this out. I'm gonna kind of heat up the beginning of it, the front of it. Oh, here we go. Okay. So we'll get that ready in the Nikola. You can check that out. It's gonna heat up for a second. All right, heat this up, and now we're gonna take this out. I love the Nikola. Blow a little bit. Yeah, you guys like Sherlocks, right? If I made a few Sherlocks, I think some people would like them. I don't know, I personally like Sherlocks. I smoke mostly flower too these days. and like mostly before bed or if I'm like sleeping in or something. That's when I tend to smoke the weed. Smoke that crazy devil's tobacco. Alright, so now we're gonna connect another blow tube over here. I have it ready, already prepped up. Then a coil out of the way a little bit. Alright. Now we're gonna connect and separate these two pieces. Stem, devil's lettuce. Thanks, Lee. I knew it was something. Devil's lettuce. All right, so who, what was the phrase I used earlier, you guys? I can't remember now. We were gonna, tell me if you've ever heard somebody use that in real, sparks your fancy. Let me know if you guys have heard somebody say that in like a real conversation or just me today. Devil's lettuce. Lee, you're smoking too much devil's lettuce over there. Yeah, I want to see you back, Lee. Even if you're not doing too much, it's good to have you in the class and it's good to have everybody. You've heard that? Yeah, maybe we should start talking in old terms. That's what I tell my son, my older son, that he can only use slang that was popular from like 1990 to maybe 2005. And that's my range of slang. But he doesn't really like that. He wants to use all kinds of words like cap and keeping it 100. He's Phi or Finna, all those things, or on God. Kenzo, do I have these right? I got them right. So, yeah, I don't know those slang words. I'm unwilling to learn. I'm good with cool, rad. Those are bad. Bad meaning good. That's right. That's my range of slang. Sick, wicked. Those two will work too. Not too shabby, that's a good one. I really do like colloquialisms though, you guys. That's my weakness. Thank you. Thanks, you guys. Yeah, this is tubing that I got from Dichroic Imagery. And yeah, I figured it would be a good one for a Sherlock. What do you think? No beans. All right, look at that beautiful tubing stretching out. That's not gonna work, we gotta move this. All right, whoa, kind of the wrong position, but I was able to manage. Okay. Oh, the bee's knees, that's a good one too. Especially people from the South, like my friend Diane. She always sends me funny colloquialisms. All right, pop that apart. Now we got our sections. You can see how that melted out. Look at that, how I stretched it out. And it was pretty hot, and I didn't lose any of the image. Pretty cool. Pretty cool tubing. Alright, so now let's attach that other opal. It's dichroic sheet in the design. Yeah. But you can do a similar thing with fuming, you're right. Yeah, you can fume. I think it's called Printer Tech. Somebody have a link for Printer Tech? There's 86 people watching. Thank you guys. Make sure you give a thumbs up. It helps the channel. motivates us to make more videos. And occasionally, we get a dad joke. I don't know, you think that's enough? I think that might be enough. One more here. Yeah, one more there. And then we'll put on a Marini or two. I gotta make the carb, right? Don't forget about the carb. Heat that up, connect that, boom, push that on. Now we're gonna pop off that bunny. What's up, Jay? How you been? How did COVID treat you? Good to see you. How's the glass blowing going? When are you gonna come out and visit me again? All right, now I gotta go in to this opal on the side. Melt that all the way around so it's nice and smooth. Now we'll go in and melt a little piece and take that off. Melt that together. Okay, there we go. I think that's looks pretty interesting. All right, let's put the carb maybe over here. Get a Marini or two on there. I think that should be cool for the piece. Let me see if I can find that cup of Marinis. Where's that cup of Marinis? I'm gonna check one place really fast. And if I can't find it, we're not gonna worry about it. We'll work on something else. Nope, I don't think I have it, you guys. So we're not gonna work on that Marinis. We can't attach any more stuff to that piece right now. All right, let's work on that other Sherlock then. Or maybe a Gandalf. A whole set of pieces, right, that match? Is that what I'm working on? I prefer the two-piece Sherlocks. Alan, I think we do want to hear the glass blowing joke, but why don't you guys decide? Alan says he has a glass blowing joke. You guys can vote if you want to hear it or not. I think I'm gonna put a bigger carb on this piece. I like that look too. Let's see what we can do with this. I'm gonna blow this out a little bit. Okay, guys? You wanna see what this looks like? Hey, Kenzo. Oh shit, you guys, my microphone was muted. I reached into my pocket and did that, but then didn't undo that. I'm back, and I've been talking to myself, I think, thanks. So I was asking if you guys are dabbing more or smoking flower. And yeah, that's the question. This is a flower piece, right? I guess we could make it a daiquiri, but I think I'm going for the flower piece. Dustin, that's a good name. Ooh, it looks like it's like half and half, like pretty much both. No clear winner. Juggalo Smurf, man, it's good to see you, man. It's been a while. A Juggalo Smurf. Oh shit, look at Kenzo. We got a voting system, a poll. Kenzo's on it. All right, time to throw in your vote. You personally. All right, we'll heat this up and just blow this out a little bit. Because I want to keep that pattern, right, you guys? I want to keep that, the look of that. No, you can't vote in the comment. You have to vote with the Kenzo system. 27 votes. Man, you guys are good voters. Did you guys all vote this year? I don't know. I bet more people are voting for this than they voted for political stuff this year. Wow, that's cool. We've never had, this is the first poll we've ever had in a chat. You guys are, we're just experimenting. All right, we'll blow this up a little bit. Just a little bit more, I think. So I'm heating up the back end a little bit because I want to expand that part a little bit more. Okay, see, like it was about 50-50. That's pretty cool. But flower won by a few points. This is a pretty good, it's a pretty good tune. But this is, oh yeah, I use this for a video. That's why I like it. Dreamer's Delight, Olives. It's a good one, it's kind of mellow. Well, how long does it take you to make a downstem? Just wondering, for a friend. Depends what kind of downstem, man. I could make a downstem in like 10 seconds if I just clip off the bottom of a bushing. Or it could take me all day if I do some detailed work. Blow this front out a little bit more, then we're gonna square this off. Toner Tech. Thanks, M. That's what it's called. Not Printer Tech, Toner Tech. All right, I know none of it's burning out yet, so that's good. Guess what, you guys? You're not gonna believe this, but it's 5 o'clock already. I know, it went by so fast because we were just having fun. You guys wanna see another stream soon? Let me know if you wanna see another stream soon. Let Kenzo know, it's really him. He's in charge. All right, heat that up. push that together a little bit. All right, now this is gonna be a special can of a new kind of Sherlock. Yeah, so you guys are pretty. If you guys want the live streams, also hit the thumbs up. That means a lot. Yeah, next time, Matt, we're gonna have an indica sativa versus a hybrid. That's not really a super fair poll because most people only are able to find a hybrid because the cannabis has been so hybridized over the years. So there's only a few like real landrace sativas and indicas, but we can go like stronger indica or stronger sativa. And there's, don't forget ruderalis. Don't forget ruderalis. What's that? What? No, we're gonna wait till next time so they have something to look forward to. The market is flooded, that is for sure. But there's always room for innovation. It's always room. There's always room for you to be yourself. All right, let's even this out a little bit. I'll let this cool so you guys can kind of check this out, what that looks like. Can you see it? Maybe here, that might be better. Oh, not really. Oh, there you go. There it comes. May even be on the black. You see, can you see the black, Kenzo? Is that too? There you guys go. Pretty cool. Oh, there we go. Nice. So it's pretty cool tubing. Pretty unique tubing. All right, but you can see it does burn out just a little bit, but it's still not bad. But it is a little bit burnt out right there on the front, just right where I closed it. All right, put this in the kiln. All right, you guys, that was the hour stream. That was really fun. It went by super fast because you guys are so entertaining. So I appreciate that. Thank you so much for watching. What day is it? It's Thursday. Maybe we'll have another stream coming up sometime soon. And we'll put a post up, maybe even a YouTube video. So yeah, thanks for watching. Thanks for being here. We'll see you soon.